This is Dr. M.L. Acharyalu, Professor, Department of History, St. Peter's Engineering College, Hyderabad. I would like to deliver a lecture about the antenna measurements. Generally, the antenna measurements are conducted in the two areas. One is the free space, just like in deserts or anechoic chambers. Deserts means the thousands of kilometers is free. That is called the line of sight 100%. So therefore it is very easy to measure the antenna measurements. But in the other case, not possible for measuring most of the time in deserts. So therefore we need to do another way, that is called the anechoic chambers. Anechoic chambers are the reflection free rooms. That means the all walls will be coated with somewhat the reflection free material, so that that measurements is generally done in public sector units or the government sectors like DRDO or HAL, like that only. Because of anechoic chambers are highly cost, that is a crores of rupees, so that's why private firms should not be make all these things. So now we'll coming to this. This is the different types of antenna measurements. The generally used to take the two types of antenna measurements. One is the absolute method gain measurement, which is the two antenna method, and other one is the three antenna method, and another one is the comparison method of gain measurement. So this is the comparison method also will take a three antenna. So now we used to take what is the antenna measurement. The antenna measurement techniques refer to the testing of antenna to ensure that the antenna meets the specifications or simply characterizing it. Why we need to measure this antenna techniques? We need to what we call the fabricate or construct an antenna, then whether it is meet specifications or not, and how to characterize the antenna parameters. So the all things will be done by using of the antenna measurements. So here the typical parameters of the antenna are gain, bandwidth, radiation patterns, beam width, and polarization, and the impedance. And these parameters will find by using of this the antenna measurements. Generally used to take a gain measurement is very important compared to the other. So because we need to take any item, first we have to get what is the output and what is the gain. So that's why always we consider the gain measurement is very important than the other parameters. Once you found the gain measurement, automatically all parameters will come with the link with that. And we will discuss some of the important points, the measurement techniques, in the upcoming sessions. So now, used to take generally, what is the requirement equipment to measure an antenna system? So generally used to take the three items, that's a source antenna and the transmitter. This antenna will have a known pattern that can be used to illuminate the test antenna. So second, the receiving system, receiver system, that is called the this determines how much power is received by the test antenna. And the other one is a position system. This system is used to rotate the test antenna related to the source antenna to measure the radiation pattern as a function of angle. So here generally in engineering colleges or where the universities or colleges, wherever it is, we have some lab, antenna lab. In that antenna lab, we have the two antenna systems. One is the transmitting and one is the receiving. And it have all these what we call the arrangements, like the power meter or whatever some meter should be get at the receiver side. And the position of the system should be changed with somewhat angle up to 0 to the 360 degrees. Like, all this equipment is necessary to measure an antenna system. So these three equipment are required. So that is everywhere it is available. So now you will coming to this. This is the test antenna, source antenna, which is fixed at the transmitter side. And the test antenna have the positioning system as well as the receiver. So this is about the antenna measurement. And now we will coming to this. This is the what is anechoic chamber. Already I told, generally used to take anechoic chamber to test an antenna system. The anechoic chambers are the indoor antenna ranges. Generally, the walls, ceiling, and the floor are lined with a special electromagnetic wave absorbing material, And indoor ranges are desired because the test conditions can be much more tightly controlled than that of the outdoor ranges. The material is often jagged in shape as well, and making the chambers quite interesting to see. So visibility is a little bit different to the common room. And the jagged triangle shapes, whatever the walls, we have to fix some material with on placed on the walls, which is in a jagged shape like a triangular. So that is the curved surfaces is there, are designed so that what is the reflected from them tends to spread in random directions. And what is added together from all the random reflections tends to add and incoherently, and is thus the suppressed further. So therefore, this is the anechoic chamber. This is the special material is made in this room, that the walls have the different materials, which is just like a sharp edges is there, the triangular edges like. So this is the transmitting and the receiving, and how the pattern will be, I mean the angle will be changed at the receiving side. So it should be noted down in the meter itself, the what is the reading, the angle 0 degrees, what is the current or whatever the power meter reading, and 5 degrees, what 10 degrees, what 15 degrees, like that, up to 90 degrees, up to 180 degrees, up to 270, up to 360. So finally you have to make the polar plot and get the radiation pattern of that antenna system. This is the measurement generally. So this is the gain measurement setup. Now we'll take the gain measurement, the most important figure of merit that describes the performance of a radiator is the gain. The choice of either depends largely on the frequency of operation. The antenna gains are not usually measured at a frequency below the 1 megahertz. Only RF range it should be operated, then it is a measurement. And usually there are the two basic methods that can be used to measure the gain of an antenna, of the electromagnetic radiator or antenna, whatever. So the absolute gain, one. Another one is the gain transfer or gain comparison method. The two types of methods we used to take for the antenna measurement. So now we'll see that what is the measurement, gain measurement. Gain measurement generally used to take the two types of antennas. One is the resonant lambda by 2 dipole antenna, another one is the pyramidal horn antenna. So here the absolute gain method is used to calibrate an antenna that can then be used as a standard for gain measurements. And it requires no no prior knowledge of the gains of the antenna system. And the gain transfer method must, it is about the absolute gain method, first one. And the gain transfer method, which is for the comparison method, for this method it must be used in conjunction with the standard gain antenna, that is a reference antenna must be neat to determine the absolute gain of the antenna under test. That means, and the first antenna what we have, the two antenna and three antenna method will be applied for the absolute gain measurement. But in a gain transfer method, we use here the one standard reference antenna at the receiver side, and the transmitting antenna is as usual, but the antenna under test is the third one. So three antenna method is applicable. So the two antenna methods are the mostly widely used, the universally accepted gain standards are resonant lambda by 2 dipole or the pyramidal horn antenna. So now we'll coming to this, the what are the fields generally used to take the near field and far field, that is called the Fresnel and Fraunhofer regions. So here Fresnel region, which is called the near field, it's a very near to the antenna, this is called the induction field, which is the phase measurement or the gain measurement, whatever it may be. So here in the far field radiation, generally used to take only far field radiation, just like this is the reference antenna, you say that the fixed antenna, and here the distant source you say that, and here this is the antenna under test. This is the setup of the gain measurement of antenna systems. So we'll coming to the two antenna method. So here absolute gain measurement, all of the methods are based on the Friis transmission equation, which assumes that the measuring system employs in the each time the two antennas. So Friis transmission equation, what is the Friis transmission equation? Friis transmission equation is the communication link between the radio, that is the transmitting and the receiving link. So that means you say that the transmitting antenna one side, receiving antenna other side, somewhat distance between them. So the PR is the received power, PT is the transmitted power, GT is the transmitting antenna gain, GR is the receiving antenna gain, and lambda is the wavelength of operating frequency. Whatever the frequency you are given, according to that wavelength will come. R is the distance between the two antennas. So this is called the Friis transmission equation. PR is equal to PT, GT, GR into lambda by 4 pi r whole square. So therefore, by using a logarithmic on both sides, and we will get somewhat the what we call logarithm applied, then R in decibels, that is GT in decibel, GR in decibel, GT plus GR is equal to 20 log of 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log of PR by PT. Then this is the gain is equivalent to the both antennas will be identical, then GT equal to GR, then 2G equivalent to the 20 log 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log PR by PT. So G equal to 1 by 2 into 20 log 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log PR by PT. We know that all the parameters PR, PT, GT and all, so therefore R and lambda, then we will find the gain of the antenna. This is about the two antenna method. The antenna are separated by distance, or already know that the far field criteria of each antenna. This is the methods, two antenna method, just now I told that, and three antenna method, exploration method, ground reflection method. So here, this is the two antenna method. The two antennas will be fixing like that. This is the Friis transmission equation. According to that, we will get this, the G naught, transmitting antenna gain plus receiving antenna gain, which is equal to 20 log of 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log of PR by PT. Where you say that gain of the transmitting antenna, which is indicated by GOT, and receiving antenna gain indicated by GOR, received power PR, transmitted power PT, antenna separation R, and the operating wavelength is lambda. This is the two antenna method. We can find the gain measurement. This is the two antenna method measurement setup. Just to observe that. The coupler is there, attenuator, tuner and all, the source, and it is called the counter, and which will be connected to a tuner adapter, and this is the receiving point, test assembly. This is test assembly A and test assembly B, and the transmit test point this is. So about the two antenna measurement like that, and now we will come into the three antenna measurement. In three antenna measurements, we say that the three antennas is there with the non-identical antennas. If the two antennas in the measuring system are not identical, so the three antenna A, B, C must be employed, and the three measurement must be made using all combinations of the three to determine the gain of each of the three antennas. So we'll take the three antennas is there, antenna A, antenna B, antenna C, have the different gains, GA, GB, GC, or you say that G1, G2, G3. So three different gains is there, and you have to connect the two antenna combinations three times, and the three antenna gain measurement will be considered from again Friis transmission equation. So used to take this is the gain of the first antenna plus second antenna gain, which is equal to 20 log of 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log of the second antenna received antenna to the transmitted antenna powers. And similarly, AC combination, GA plus GC equal to 20 log of 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log of PC by PA. And similarly, you say that BC combination, here the gain of the B antenna plus gain of the C antenna, which is equal to 20 log of 4 pi r by lambda plus 10 log of received power of the C antenna by received power of the B antenna. So the three combinations will give the calculation part and will evaluate the gain of the antenna system. This is the three antenna gain measurement method. And the last one, extrapolation gain measurement. The extrapolation measurement is an absolute gain method and which can be used with the three antenna method. It was developed to rigorously account for the possible errors due to proximity, multipath and the non-identical antennas. This is extrapolation gain measurement, which is possible to identify errors to the proximity, the multipath and the non-identical antennas. If none of the antenna used in this measurement are circularly polarized, the method yields the gains and the polarizations of all three antennas. If only one antenna is circularly polarized, this method yields only the gain and polarization of the circularly polarized antenna. Right? The method fails if the two or more antennas are circularly polarized. If the two or more antennas are circularly polarized, then this method should not be successful. Okay. So, this is about the exploration gain measurement. Now, the last one, and the ground reflection range measurement, which is the comparison method. So, a method that can be used to measure the gain of the moderately broad beam antenna, usually for the frequency below 1 gigahertz. The method takes into account the specular reflections from the ground, that is the system geometry of the figure as shown in side. So, here, and it can be used with some restrictions and the modifications with the two or three antenna methods. So, here just we will the ground reflection method like this. If we will coming to the what we call comparison method, we used to take three antennas. One antenna is the generally used to take, it requires the three antennas and the gain, let we consider that the G1, G2, G3 respectively, and the transmitting antenna gain you say that the G1, and the reference antenna or the isotropic reference antenna gain we take the G2, and the antenna under test is a G3. Here we have know the gain of the reference antenna already. So therefore, by keeping switch, the receiver side have the two antennas, one is the reference antenna, other one is the antenna under test, and left side far distance the transmitting antenna is available. When the transmitting antenna is on, then the receiver switch should be connected to the reference antenna. First we need to find the received power and find the gain automatically. Reference antenna gain already we know that. Then we will find what is the power is received at this antenna. We will fix that power by applying the Friis transmission equation, and the received power at the antenna 2, that is called the reference antenna, PR2 equal to PT1 and transmitting antenna gain into transmitting antenna power transmitted at the transmitting antenna, PT1 into G1 into G2 into of lambda by 4 pi r whole square. That is, you say that the equation number 1. And now we'll coming to the switch position should be changed to the antenna under test side from the receiver. Then you used to take the how much power is received by the antenna under test, which is taken to the account. So therefore, PR3 is equal to, that means the received power at the antenna 3 by using the Friis transmission equation, and the PT1 transmitting antenna power flow at the transmitting antenna, transmitted power into of transmitting antenna gain G1 and the gain of the antenna under test, which is indicated by G3, into of lambda by 4 pi r whole square. So from the above equations 1 and 2, PR2 and PR3, the ratio of these two equations, PR2 by PR3 is equal to, except G2 and G3, all will be cancelled, because PT G1 G2 into lambda by 4 pi r whole square whole by PT G1 G3 into lambda by 4 pi r whole square, except G2 and G3, all will be cancelled. Therefore, PR2 by PR3 is equal to G2 by G3, where G2 is the gain of the reference antenna, G3 is the gain of the antenna under test. Now we are going to find the antenna under test gain only. So therefore, G3 equal to PR3 by PR2 into G2, where PR3 is the, again you rewrite that, G3 equivalent to the received power of the antenna under test, the ratio of the received power of the antenna under test to the received power of the reference antenna into the gain of the reference antenna. This is about the comparison method, and